Hey, Tater Baters, what's going on? You ready for another ride? Let's go. Where is it?
I see it.
Well, they put me in a tight spot.
They always do. Assholes. Okay, ready?
Yeah. Look at that, but it's back in the champ on it, man. You hear what I said?
Nope.
I said I'm back. I got right up on it. See that?
Good for you. You didn't have anything attached.
But I did it first try.
So I could do that too first try.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No girl can do that.
Huh?
No girl can drive a truck.
Oh, bullshit.
It's a guy's job.
Bullshit.
All a woman and girl for is cooking and cleaning.
I drove military trucks too.
Yeah.
I drove trailers.
I just saw pictures. I didn't see videos of you guys driving it. Right, bitch?
I don't think I have any videos.
Exactly. So point taken.
Point taken nothing.
I'm confused.
I would have freaking gotten in trouble. Now this is awkward.
Yeah.
So I don't know what the hell to light.
Just go, I'll play the phone.
You're going straight.
Okay. So I finally decided to do a video, and I wanted to do a video yesterday, but I could not do it because the weather's bad and my partner could not make it in, so that's why I haven't did it. I did give you guys an update video. I hate the snow, I hate it all, kills the joints, so.
You're turning right.
So I didn't get to do much between helping my dad out because he got stuck and keeping him calm and stuff like that, so that definitely took the rest of my day up and shit. So that was my day yesterday. I'm just tired of this fucking weather already. I wish it would fucking stop. I mean, Florida is definitely calling my name.
Me too.
I can't take her with me. She's heading nuts.
You turn them right. I don't need you. I got family down there.
I got somebody else down there too. So there.
My mother-in-law is down there. I have an aunt down there. I have another aunt and uncle down there. So my aunt and uncle on my side of the family live right near freaking Disney World.
What part is that?
Well, Disney is in Orlando.
Okay.
Stay to the left. So they're in Kissimmee, I think, which is like right outside of Orlando.
Right.
And then, my mother-in-law is in Lake Okeechobee, which is about 3 hours.
Okay.
And then my aunt is, my husband's aunt is in Port St. Lucie, which is about 3 hours
So I'm gonna go on to a rant. I actually got a good one for you crazy motherfuckers today. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell you this story right here. I have my own house. I have my own house. And everything. My dad actually designed my house for me. But my mom doesn't live with me. I live on my own kind of thing. I have my friend come in and take care of me. My friends, more than one, sorry. But to keep the long story short, my real mom lives in a different area, so she was telling me she wanted me to move to New York. And I cannot do that because I have stuff going on with me. And if I move to New York, I lose my benefits. So, with that being said, my mom and I are arguing about this a couple days ago. And I finally said, you know what? Fuck it. Because, you know, she's not gonna give up on me, she's not gonna lay up on me, or whatever you want to say to what it is. But I just got so tired of hearing this shit. So you know what I told my mom? I said, you know what? You go to New York and you do what you need to do. And you want to retire and this and that, and you want me to come with you? Well, sometimes I told her I can't do that. So, you know, we just argue back and forth. And then I just went on and on and on and on. And I just said, what the fuck, man? I can't give up. And you won't give up on shit and stuff like that. So it's just like I can't win no more. And I finally got her convinced that after my dad said, you know, if I move to New York or any other state in the world and permanently live there, I lose my benefits. So then my sister said something my mother about moving to Wisconsin. What the fuck? To Wisconsin. And which put that idea back in my head that I should move to Wisconsin with her. I know people that live in Wisconsin, sorry for saying this, but Wisconsin sucks because it's always cold in the wintertime and I cannot take the cold. And I would never want to live there. I need nothing to do besides parks. And since when do you think I can be in a park, go on a water ride when I can't walk or move myself around? So, reality, do you really think I would have fun in Wisconsin? Fuck no. So, that's my rant on that one. However, here's another one for you. I'll space it out for you, so just enjoy the ride for now.
Place like home.
Girl.
Trust me, I've lived away.
You don't like it?
My family is here. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. You're gonna turn right.
You had to stop, okay?
Yes, I know. I was stopping.
Yeah, you're
but stuck. You have a heavy load, so it wasn't stopping as quickly as I was trying to.
You guys ready for the second part of this, right? Here it goes. Can you turn the camera so that you can see me, please?
You're gonna be going to the right.
Copy that, loud and clear. But anyway, I had two pallet chairs here, so my dad says to me, why don't you ask your mom if she wants the old one? So I said, sure, I'll ask her. Am I turning here? No,
stay straight.
You told me to turn.
Well, that's what it was looking like.
So, sorry about that. My partner screwed me over.
So,
I asked her. She said yes. So, however, she asked me if I could bring the power chair into the house. And I said, yeah, as long as her husband could hear it open, and he's fully capable of doing that, but he just doesn't. I don't think he will. So my mom asked me if it's okay if Jeff and somebody else which is my stepdad, says that if they carry it on the steps. I said, are you fucking crazy? I think we're a 400-pounder. And I said, no, that's not gonna happen. I said, if you want Jeff to carry up the stats, then it's not coming up. I said, even if he could carry up the stats, my friends, my supporters, I couldn't go through the house with the chair anyway. Because my mom is how I should take a trailer. It is a double Y 20 by 40. And that won't work. And she's got the washer and dryer right beside the outdoor hike and inside of the house entrance. And so, can you please give me an idea in the comments if you think that's possible? If there's a washer and dryer right beside the door, and his shoes over the fucking floor and shit, and I don't think that would be a good idea if I bring a $42,000 chair to the house so they can carry it up the steps. I really don't think that's going to really go over really well. I mean, my stepdad's a bigger dude, but at the same time, I just don't see it happening, you know? I mean, I'm not saying that he's weak or anything, but damn, I mean, he has some common sense, you know? But yeah, that's what's going on in the house. Turn the camera around. And I'll see you on the other side.
You're welcome.
When I get the load dropped off here, I'm going to show you my new keyboard that I promised I was going to show you a long time ago, and I really apologize for that. Like I said, it was just because of the bad weather coming up, and I didn't want my friend driving through it. So, either way,
Running out of fuel? Holy shit.
I told her to take the day off, or, you know, make her best judgment, so. That's why there's no videos coming out. I mean, they should be coming out now. But, it depends on what she, how the weather comes, you know. She lives up on a mountain, so.
Yeah, we had a blizzard. 26 inches of snow.
So.
Two days to dig out. And the roads are still bad today, but better than the past 2 days.
I mean, I'm grateful that she's here today, but. It would have been nice to have the videos off for you guys, but I did the best I could of what I had. And it seemed like you guys don't get to talk in the video, which is, I understand. You guys are at the games and you had to hear the truck and stuff. I understand that. I totally get it. You know, I understand it and stuff. That's, I want to hear people's drama either. I'm used to hearing people's shit from other people, but at the same time, it's just really weird and shit.
You're gonna be turning off to the right here.
Alright, as soon as I get it straight, I'm gonna have to change the view a little bit so they have something else to watch.
Then it's going into a toll booth.
I'm not going through here. Right?
Yep.
Should have bought some mana today. Don't have a part on YouTube again.
Yeah, right. Your dad would kill me.
Who are you watching her?
Jake. He's home from school today.
Okay. So, how are you feeling? The name is
Tired as always.
Tired as always.
Oh, this is awful. I can't wait till they figure out what the hell is wrong with me.
Well, I didn't tell you what's wrong with you.
What?
You come here.
Maybe it's something in the air here.
Really?
No, because I feel the same when I'm home. Oh my god, I was surprised I was actually able to pull my ass off the couch to get some stuff done around the house the past 2 days. It was like spread out, but I got some stuff done.
What did you get done?
Laundry. My room. My room still isn't even done. Like, we pulled all the furniture out and swept. Oh my god, the dust bunnies that were underneath the bed and the dressers. And I had a bunch of paperwork in the closet, just waiting to get sorted through to put in the fire safe and stuff, so I finally got to doing all that yesterday.
Uh-huh.
You know, just little things.
My guess is that she has sleep apnea.
I pray to God I don't.
You act like my dad. She doesn't have that mask on.
See, I'm worried about, you know, how am I going to sleep with that thing on my face.
You got to get used to it.
Well, trust I'm me. Sure. Like, I just...
Now, my dad got so used to it, now he can't sleep without it, so...
That's what, when I went to pick up that little device this morning, that's what the guy said. You know, that get used to it.
Yeah.
Go all the way around. And then turn down there. Yeah, you said did you get used to it, and then if you go anywhere, you take that thing with you, camping or vacations, you know, hotels.
Yeah, that's pretty new.
That you take it everywhere with you. I just worry because I toss and turn, you know, so.
You know, that you made the one that I probably knows. You know what I'm talking about?
Like oxygen?
Yeah.
Well, that would be ideal if that was the case. Because, like, the little device that they gave me to do tonight, I could probably handle something like that. But what that device will do is check to see if I have any shallow breathing or any periods of sleep apnea. And with that, they'll decide whether or not I have to go for a complete sleep study or not.
I mean, the way you're acting right now and the way you've been these couple weeks, I mean, I hate to say it, but it looks like it's like what you have. And probably from the Army, too, from, you know, not getting enough sleep and stuff like that.
Right.
I'm sure you didn't get enough comfortable, very comfortable.
Oh, no. And think how long I've been dealing with insomnia for a very long, since, like, 2009.
Yeah.
When I was in Iraq the first time.
Right.
There's one of those roundabouts coming, but you're just going to pretty much turn right.
I hope I get a gas station soon.
Has to be the wait, because we went through that gas quick.
I saw me going an asshole before.
No, it's the wait.
And if you do get the foam mask thing going on, then it's not too bad, because it's check.
What number do you hit for the
I have
7. 7, 10, 9, 8, 7.
All right, I'll get it. Go to yes, please. Sorry, folks, you ran out of gas.
We have a big, heavy load. Suck all our fuel. That was about the car. It was all state calling.
Do you mean to take that or call them or?
When we're done.
Okay, go ahead. Can you wait a minute? Have someone again? Oh, shit, I gotta figure that out. Sorry, folks. Come on. Well, which way am I going here? That one I,
but it's not showing us, it's not lit up.
It will only start driving.
All right.
hopefully I'll make the right decision. Please bear with me here. I hate when a GPS tells us. Which was it right there? Can't really tell, can you?
No, because I don't know where I'm at. Here we are.
Yeah.
So, holy shit.
Let's just make a right hand turn.
Yeah, looks like we can maybe. Yeah, let's just.
Alright. Too close.
We can work with that.
Okay, let's go. Sorry about that, folks.
We still need gas. They only gave us a little bit.
Gas station anywhere, let me know.
Right. Okay, so you're going to be going straight.
Yeah.
So I don't know why these
assholes. The mask that my dad wears has a strap around his head, and it sort of follows you all over the place.
Right.
You just gotta worry about the tubing.
Right. Stay to the right because I'm not sure how this road is gonna be. We have to get off here. That's what it's looking like. Yeah, turn right. I get a gas station somewhere. Don't go too fast because I don't want to waste too much gas. Thank you.
So if you like what you see and you want to see more, it's cool. Hand number one, if you can. Sorry about the noise, people. Some big arm got in my way. I'm trying to fix that right now.
Okay, turn to the right.
I did not feel in the beginning of this journey because it was so long, and I figured you guys wanted to see me afford a little more. But anyway, I did have a tractor pull out in front of me. I took a picture of it.
Oh yeah, that was cool. That was the first time we saw something like that.
Yeah.
Dijon. Like Dijon mustard.
I'm hungry now. Alright, you can sort out my junk and we'll stop here for now. Okay, folks, you can turn that camera on real quick. Hey, folks, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop here on the film. The next journey sometime today. It probably won't be up until tomorrow or the next day. I will see you on the other side. I promise you I'll be back as soon as you see I'll be here. So I'll see you soon. And tell those other people to fucking stop even the horn at me. Peace.